SpiceJet gets its first of the 205 Boeing MAX planes that it had ordered last year. Sonia, in fact, caught up with Ajay Singh, the chairman and MD of SpiceJet, and began by asking him how the new planes will help in bringing down costs for the company.
As you know, we've ordered 205 aircraft. This is the 737 MAX aircraft. It's the new technology from Boeing. This has several great features, both for the airlines as well as for consumers. As you said, the fuel burn for this aircraft is a lot less. We'll burn 14% less fuel, which is incredibly important at this crazy time when oil prices have gone up and are so high now. In addition to that, this is truly a green plane. So this has a far smaller noise footprint, about 40% smaller noise footprint. The NOx emissions are significantly lower, about 30-40% lower than the old plane. So I think from an airline's perspective, it's a lower cost plane, both in terms of fuel burn as well as in terms of engineering cost, which is about 25-30% lower for this aircraft.
Lower cost is something that you guys have been doing for a while, right? Even in the quarter gone by, you were the only airline that actually managed to hold on to your yields. What are the cost reduction plans that the company has going forward?
Well, at this time, I think the most important plan for us is that we induct more and more of these aircraft so that the cost of fuel comes down. We also want to fly to destinations that have lower VAT, states, airports that have lower VAT on aviation turbine fuel. We need to try and figure ways of increasing revenue. I think that's critical for the aviation sector today, that some of the costs, the additional costs that we've incurred as a consequence of the rupee depreciating and the oil price going up is passed on to consumers. And we believe that that should happen soon as the festive season kicks in. Airlines will try and take up fares. Today, the fares are absurdly low. You know, sometimes it costs more to travel by taxi to the airport than it does to fly from one airport to the other.
It does.
You know, at an average of 3,700 rupees, Delhi-Mumbai.
But you know, why is the industry not coming together and raising prices, you know, together?
I think what tends to happen is that there are some players who are getting a lot of capacity in the market, and because they need to fill those planes, they try and sell cheap, and that keeps the fares depressed. I think there is a general sentiment in the industry that fares need to go up. They really do need to go up, and I believe that it should happen really soon.
So you're saying fares will go up very
fares
soon?
Fares will go up, and I think they will become more rational than they are today.
Is it true that in the last 15 days, you know, we do 15-day data of the fares moving for 500 domestic routes. We've noticed that cumulatively, a lot of the companies have increased prices by an average of around 1,500 rupees. Is that correct? And is that something that will sort of translate into better earnings in the December quarter?
All airlines are looking for opportunities to pass on some of the additional cost. And I'm not sure about the 1,500 rupee number, but remember that we are coming off a weak period of flying, which is the September month is the weakest. There's also a Shradh period, which ended sort of on 8th of October. So you will see yields hardening and hopefully better earnings for the December quarter than you will see in the September quarter.
Okay. I'm going to come back to earnings in a bit, but I want to take up one point you mentioned, that you're going to fly to routes where there's a lower VAT. What do you see as the move from the government?
It's important that all airlines around the world have the benefit of having aviation fuel at a much lower cost, because it is either they are not taxed on aviation fuel, or if they are taxed, then aviation fuel is part of their GST regimes, and therefore they get input credit. So the net effective tax on ATF is zero. So we need that to happen in our country. You know, we are speaking to government on both the issues, which is that, on excise duty on ATF used to be 8%. It was high, but it was 8%. And as oil prices came down, they increased. So as oil prices have gone back up again and the rupee is depreciated as well, we've requested that this be brought down to 8% again. It's for government to see what is to be done.
So, there's talk of no import duty on the engineering parts, giving an infrastructure status to the aviation sector. Do you think any of that will help at all?
You know, of course it will help. Of course. Import duty on IGST, which has been imposed on engineering components. Now, what happens is that this used to be zero. Once the GST regime came, this they imposed this IGST on engines. So, an engine typically goes through its life two or three times. It goes for a shop visit. Every time it comes back, if you tax it, then it becomes extremely expensive. And we have raised this with government and said, look, there is no repair facility within our country. We need to send it out. No country in the world taxes, aviation services like this. So we hope that some of these, issues will be looked at and changes made.
With the way crude prices are headed, with the way the rupee has moved, you think that this industry is headed for much more in terms of losses, and for SpiceJet as well? I mean, you've been relatively doing better than the others, but do you see more losses in the quarters to come?
One thing that we are doing to reduce cost is to get more of these new planes in, because these planes burn 14% less fuel, as I said to you. Engineering cost is about 30% less. So because of that, the overall cost comes down more than 10%. So that is something that airlines have to do. They have to get new technology. They have to try and reduce their own cost base. And more importantly, they need to increase their fares. There's no, when there is a market with such terrific demand, you can keep putting in planes and keep filling them, right? Market has been growing 20% year on year, and it is the fastest growing market in the world.